People of Earth, how are you? I can't believe it's Saturday night once again. Time for episode 43 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Live from Mount Laurel, New Jersey. With me, your host and number one camp girl, Will Spence. Nice and gold. As always, an auspicious day. This 6th of February, 2021. Born on this day, Rick Astley, in 1966. And I really should Rickroll y'all tonight, but I'm not going to do that. Also, Canadian music legend Gord Downie was born in 1964. He passed away in 2017. Ask any Canadian who Gord Downie is, and then they'll say, yeah, he's my fave. Leader of the Tragically Hip, big independent band in Canada. Natalie Cole, birthday today. She passed away in 2015. Ronald Reagan, Zsa Zsa Gabor, Bob Marley, Babe Ruth. Man, those Aquarians. All over the place. For your entertainment history this week, on this day in 1966, if your time machine television worked, you could be watching the debut of Mr. Ed. Wilbur. Hit me off of this bridle path, Wilbur. I'm not a workhorse. I'm a playboy. And back before television in 1936, a little guy named A. Hitler opened the 4th Winter Olympics. A few years later, another better guy named Charles de Gaulle opened the 19th Winter Olympics in 1968. And that's about it. Tomorrow we got the Super Bowl. And yeah, who cares? I certainly don't. But for our first song tonight, we're getting into that Wayback Machine, going back to 1951. And this is from the I Bet You Didn't Know This Song Had Lyrics collection. And we'll see what you think of this. I love Lucy, and she loves me. We're as happy as two can be. Sometimes we quarrel, but then how we love making it up again. Lucy kisses like no one can. She's my missus, and I'm her man. And life is heaven, you see, 'cause I love Lucy, yes, I love Lucy, and Lucy loves me. Favorite book of TV theme songs. Written in 1951 by Academy Award nominees Elliot Daniel wrote the music, and Harold Adamson a few years later wrote the lyrics. And Ricky Ricardo sang those lyrics in the 1953 episode called Lucy's Last Birthday. So, there you go. Who knew? And frankly, who cared? But, you know, I care. I care enough to bring you the oddball stuff. I want you to check my thing, my recording device. That's what I need to check to make sure all three people who joined in 5 minutes ago have gone away. Oh, we got suckers on the line here. Yes, indeed. I got some splaining to do. So, I try to do some splaining. Sometimes things just go this way with songs that I'm planning to do. None of the things that were on my list this morning actually made the cut, because when the rubber hits the road with these things, and by rubber I mean these floppy digits, and by the road I mean this unyielding keyboard, if I can't pull it off, then I'm not going to try to attempt it. And hence, I will apologize to Alan Dauber. I had every intention of playing your request this evening, but I'll have to get to it. I've got a pile of I'll have to get to it songs in various places in my big, thick notebook. So, this is why I drink. Kenny Loggins was 17 years old when he wrote this song. And Loggins and Messina released it in 1971 on the Sittin' In LP. It, although a year before the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band recorded it, 1970. But it did go to number 53 on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 charts in 1971, and I've always liked this song.
Back to the days of Christopher Robin. Back to
days of boom. Next song I've played before. The Christopher Robin. It's been covered by a few people, but most notably in my mind, and I didn't see it. I'm gonna have to look it up on Netflix or whatever with the streaming services that must still carry this. Uncle Jesse, Uncle Joey, and Danny on one of the last episodes of Full House in 1995. They sang that song in three-part harmony, and that must have been just fabulous. Johnny Rivers in 1965, and then Glenn Campbell in 1967, had big hits with By the Time I Get to Phoenix. Then Glenn kind of liked the geographical theme. Then he went to the songwriter of By the Time I Get to Phoenix, that's Jimmy Webb, and said, "Jimmy, how about another geographical tune?" And, Jimmy came up with this one that turned into a number three hit for Glenn Campbell in 1968. He recorded it with the Wrecking Crew in L.A. He was actually a part-time member of the Wrecking Crew in L.A., great guitar player, Glenn Campbell. And that's your assignment this week. Look up the Wrecking Crew and see how many people, how many hit records that they played. Great bunch of studio musicians in L.A. back in the day when music was good, like this song. I am a lineman for the county, and I drive the main road, searching the sun for another overload. I hear you singing in the wires, I can hear you through the wine, and the Wichita lineman is still on the line. Small vacation, but it don't look like rain. And if it snows, that stretch down south won't ever stand the strain. And I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time. Wichita lineman is still on the line is still on the line. Title track of their third album from 1974, and an unbroken streak of Steely Dan songs for me as per my New Year's resolution for this year. Getting harder every week. Cover photo was taken at 79th Street and 5th Avenue at the Miner's Gate entrance to Central Park. Pretzel vendor with a spelling problem. Released in 1974, went to number 57, and was distinctive in that it was the first song that the guitar solo featured was done by Walter Becker. And he further came out of his shell in that role. And of course, there will be no guitar solo in this. There will be no Walter Becker. There will be no Donald Fagen. That's it. It's only me, and you gotta go. That's all you got. I would love to tour the Southland in a traveling minstrel show. Yes, I'd love to tour the Southland in a traveling minstrel show. Yes, I'm dying to be a star, make them laugh. The sound is like a record on the phonograph. These days are gone forever. Over a long time ago. Oh yeah. I've never met Napoleon, but I plan to find the time. Napoleon, but I plan to find the time. Yes, I do. Cause it looks so fine on that hill. They tell me he was lonely, he's lonely still. Those days are gone forever, over a long time ago. Oh, yeah. Thank you. stepped up on the platform. Man gave me the news. He said, you must be joking, son. But did you get those shoes? Where did you get those shoes? Well, I seen them on the TV, the movie show. They say the times are changing, but I just don't know. These things are gone forever. All the notes. I'm going to go to one of my little numbers. And see how this goes. A song of pining. Which could be for anybody. Yeah, it's mine from 1987. Okay. Thank you. Katie, that's it for me tonight. Episode 43. If you're in my area, or enjoy the snow that's coming overnight. Just what we need. Another anywhere from 3 to 8 inches predicted, starting overnight. And then some more on Wednesday. I'll tell you what, I better have a clear path on Thursday, because I'm going to get my second dose of the vaccine. And here's to the vaccine. Here's to the science. Here's to you. Thanks for joining me tonight. And assuming I'm not writhing in side effects from the second dosage next week, I will be back for episode 44 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Till then, thanks once again, and ciao, ciao.